The first step when you are using BIM 360 Design on a project with Civil 3D is to create your project in BIM 360 Design. The user begins by filling out project-specific information such as project name, project type, project start and end date, and the BIM 360 field project language if this is applicable on your project. These values are the minimum that you have to fill out in the Create Project profile. If you have an image that represents this project, you can add it to the profile. Once the desired information has been filled out, you need to save and continue. The next step, which is step 2 of 2, you need to activate the services that you will need for the project. Here we will activate document management, project management, and design collaboration. When activating document management, you have the option to copy an existing project settings, but for now we will just assign a project administrator for this service. You have the ability to set up multiple project administrators at this time if you wish. We will add the administrators for project management and design collaboration in the same manner. Select Finish, and the project is created in BIM 360 Design. Once the project has been created, you are now ready to add the project members. Members can be added from multiple companies if needed, and you can prescribe the role they will be taking on for the project. New members can be added to the project at any time. Administrative privileges can be given at this point or taken away. As an administrator, you can control these rights at the project level. You can also give members rights to have access to specific services when you are a project administrator. If you did not elect to copy an existing project settings when you created your new project, then you will need to access document management to create your company's folder system. Simply add folders to mimic your company's typical folder structure for a new project. And once your project folders have been set up, a project administrator can set permissions for each folder or a set of folders. Select the ellipsis next to the desired folder and pick permissions. Inside the permissions dialog, you can add team members and give those members a specific permission level to view, download, upload, edit, or a combination thereof. For administrative type controls, you can set the permissions to the folder control setting. At any time, these permissions can be updated by the administrator.